This time, I will start with the first part out of three about the void planning with linear. When the design is done, we come to the point where collisions of the technical systems with the architecture need to be resolved. Therefore, we want to specify openings in walls and ceilings in order to avoid time-consuming cutting or drilling afterwards in the construction phase. This design must be carefully coordinated with the architect or structural engineer to ensure actual feasibility. For this reason, the MEP designer can only define his requirements or wishes in the first step and then communicate them to the other parties involved. He does this in a 3D building model with so-called provision for voids, which means placeholders or opening proposals. I will show you how to do this effectively with linear today. We're going to start by manually placing a placeholder, and we want to use it to make an opening proposal for this ventilation duct through the wall. For this, we will choose a rectangular placeholder in the wall and define the distance between the duct and the wall to be 50 millimeters. After starting the command, we are first asked to select the wall and then the components for which we want to generate a placeholder. These can be single as well as bundles of pipes and ducts. So we do this here first for the single ventilation duct and then for the neighboring pipe bundle. As you can see, you can very easily control how placeholders are created, always implementing the correct height and the necessary distance to the ducts or pipes. To speed up the process massively, we also offer you an automatic generation of placeholders within an area or even complete construction sections selected by you, whereby you also have the possibility to define all relevant options in order to control very precisely what should happen automatically. For example, you define how the distances between installations and the architecture should be. You define whether you want to create round or rectangular placeholders, or whether the placeholders should be created in walls and ceilings at the same time, and from which minimum distance you want to combine placeholders that are close to each other into one. In this case, we select two walls and then the systems for which you want to generate the provisions. Now the program determines the best possible implementation and places the provision for voids into the model. It can be as simple as that. Finally, I will show you how you can also label these placeholders. Just choose a label appropriate to the situation. Here in my case, I want to label the provision with heights relative to the bottom edge of the ceiling. So I choose UEBEC, which means the distance from the upper edge of the provision to the bottom edge of the ceiling. The label is generated and can then be freely placed. Up to this point, we have now defined our requirement in the form of placeholders for slots and openings. And in the next step, we can communicate this to the other parties involved for the purpose of coordination. In the next video, I will show you how this communication with the architect or structural engineer can be optimally implemented. This is how easy it is to place provisions in the linear void planning. That's workflow instead of workaround.